we should know first what is grating. So normally when we are having a slits, okay, so we want to make a slits. So slits can be made with the help of opaque surface, and in between that opaque surface we are having a transparent surface, and that transparent surface acts like a slit. So normally this is our slit. So here you can see we are having an opaque surface, and between opaque surface we are having a transparent thing, open thing, that is acting like a slit. So this slit is of a very large thickness. Now we want to make a slits which is very very fine and they are very close to each other. So that type of slits is made with the help of a grating. Okay, so we are having a grating. In grating, what we do, we take a transparent material like a glass and we draw a number of lines on the glass. Okay, so and that number of lines is very much high. That is, in our case, the grating which we are using is having around 15,000 lines per inch, means in 1 inch, which is around 2.54 centimeter, we are having 15,000 lines. So much compact this grating is. If you see it by your naked eye, you will not feel the difference. This is our grating, okay? So this is your transmission grating. And if you see, it looks like just a transparent glass material, but it's not a transparent glass. And we have drawn a small lines, and that small line act as a opaque surface, and the line which we have not drawn is acting like a transparent surface, and we are having a number of slits. So how many slits we are having here? We are having around 15,000 slits per inch. So compact it is. Okay. So first is, in this experiment, it contains three different parts. In first part, we have to do the mounting of this grating. So how to mount this grating on the spectrometer, that is our first part. Then we will find the grating element, and then we will find the separation, separation distance between two images. So these are our all things which we have to do in this experiment. So we will start with the mounting. So how to get the mounting one? So first you have to see this direct image. Okay. So this is the slit which we are having. The slit is giving us, this is passing from the collimator, and from here we are having a grating, and from the grating we are getting the image on the telescope. So we feel that this is in a straight line. Okay. So if it is in a straight line, it means the angle between your collimator and your telescope is 180 degree. Now we have to mount this grating which is perpendicular to the collimator. That we have to do. So first we will take the reading, this reading, and this reading I will write it down. Okay, so we will write down this reading. Suppose that reading is A. So the reading which we have written is A. I am not taking the vernier part here. It's around 122 degree. So it's around 122 degree. Okay. Now what you have to do? You have to rotate the telescope such that the angle is plus or minus 90 degree. Okay. So I will rotate it. So plus or minus 90 degree means it will become 212 degree. So and you have to, in the entire reading, you have to take only one window. So this is the window which I am taking. So I will rotate it by 212 degree. So I will keep it around, put it like this. Now, yeah. Now you can see it has become around 212 degree. So now my reading is around 212 degree. Okay. So in this way, this collimator, and here we are having the separation is around 90 degree. Now what you have to do? You have to rotate this prism table such that the light which is coming from this slit is getting reflected from this grating and is coming to the collimator. So I will rotate this. Okay. And while rotating, I will try to see it with the help of telescope. Yes, I got this. So I am getting the reading, which is so I am getting the reflection here. Earlier it was the angle which is around 90 degree between collimator and telescope. Now what has happened? The angle between your telescope, this incident angle, the angle between this beam and this axis is the incident angle. So now incident angle and the reflection angle is always equal. And here we can see the incident angle and reflection. This angle is around 90 degree. That we know, okay, the angle between collimator and your telescope, that we have adjusted, and this is 90 degree. This we know. Now, what is the angle of incident? This angle is around 45 degree. But this is a line, and you know that from linear angle, the total angle is around 180 degree. So this is 90. So this angle plus this angle both are equal. So both are 90. So one angle will become 45 degree. So this angle, incident angle, is around 45 degree. Okay. Now you have to take reading again. So if I take the reading again, I can see it's around 258 degree. Okay, so I am getting the reading which is around B, and that reading is around 258 degree. Okay, so this reading is around 258 degree. Now this is my B value. So I have got the value B, which is 258 degree. Okay, that we have done. Now you have to find, you have to rotate it. This, since the angle is around 45 degree, so I have to add or subtract 45 degree to this. So if you subtract 45 degree, what answer I will get? 45 means it is 3. This is 1, 2, 1, 3 degree. So you have to rotate it again to 2, 1, 3 degree. So I rotate this prism table to again 2, 1, 3 degree. 2, 1, 10, 100, 2, 3. Okay, so 213 degree. Now if I rotate this here, now your grating is perpendicular. Okay, so now the grating has become perpendicular. So now this, the angle between this and your incident angle is 90 degree. So this is the first step you have to do for the mounting. Okay, now after doing this the grating, remember that the grating will disperse the line, and you will get the dispersed pattern, first order and second order dispersion. So we will try to find the grating element with the help of the formula. So for that, what you have to do, you have to take the reading, direct reading we have taken. Now we have to take the direct reading, and this direct reading will be common for all the readings. Now I will try to move this and get the first order. So if I rotate it, here I am getting the first order. So this is first order diffraction. Okay, so diffractions, this is the first order. Okay, and I will take the reading of same window. Now I will move it little more. So I have moved it little more. Yes, and I am getting the second order here. So I am getting the second order here. So this is the second order reading. So first order I have got it around here, and we have found the angle. That angle is for first order, and then we have moved it to the second order, and second order also I have found the angle. This is for second order. So what you have to do, we have got the straight reading. This is for first mounting we have done. Now for finding the grating element, you have to take the reading for the first order diffraction and then the second order diffraction. Okay, so we have found this value, and then I will subtract the first order from the main, from the this, from this reading, from the direct reading, you will get this angle theta. So I will take the reading on left hand side, and then I will take the reading, same reading on right hand side. So two reading I will take it on first order reading on left hand side, okay, then second order reading on left hand side, then I will move it to the right hand side, this side and this side, and two readings again. So one and two. So two first order and second order, two more reading we have done. So in this, we have completed the taking the reading. So how to go ahead, I will show you. Okay, so what are the things which we have done? If you will look here, we have done this, mounting is done,